we touch spaces with all of the sciences, and because of that there is a lot of overlap.
When I was a little kid, I never had the I want to be a ballerina phase. I always wanted to be a scientist.
I've always had a passion for nature, so when I was kind of considering what kind of career that might interest me in the future, I always knew it would be something to do with nature and life and kind of understanding how living things work.
At first I wanted to do medicine because I knew I was interested in that area of science, like kind of drug action within bodies, within the human body, stuff like this. But I didn't want to be a doctor.
To be perfectly honest, I'm still a chemist at heart. But the chemistry that's involved in living systems is so beautiful.
I kind of looked up this subject that I thought sounded pretty cool, like looking at the chemistry that underpins life. I thought, I'd give that a go.
I started off by studying chemistry, and I found that the most exciting parts of chemistry were the application to biological systems, and that I could use my chemical knowledge to understand biology.
There is exquisite control of the chemistry that's going on, of the chemical reactions that are happening, of the molecules that are being built. And this is a level of control that chemists can only dream about.
Without kind of application to nature and life, chemistry just seemed a bit dull and dry to me, which my chemist friends will probably kill me for saying.
So I looked at biochemistry and thought, you know, if you really, really, really want to see beautiful chemistry and study beautiful chemistry, this is the place to do it. The biochemistry course really concentrates on the molecular basis for life, how life works at the level of individual molecules.
The students most suitable for a biochemistry degree are those who have definitely enjoyed chemistry at A-level and enjoyed biology too.
The biochemistry course at Oxford is a very broad course compared to most other universities.
It touches bases with all of the sciences, and because of that there is a lot of overlap with your like chemistry, medicine, biology and physics to a small degree.
The reason we have a broad course is because it enables people to integrate information from lots of different areas. And that's the way that you get to answer really interesting questions.
In the first year, people studied for what's called the prelims, in which they study a variety of different subjects, you know, chemistry, biophysical chemistry, molecular cell biology, maths. And that's really a foundational year that gives you the chemistry and maths background to be able to understand the rest of the course.
In the second and third year, the course is divided into four main areas, ranging from biophysics through to cell biology. And everybody has to do all four courses, but they get some choice as to the areas within those four courses that they want to specialise in.
One of the things that we offer is in your second and fourth year, you can take additional options where you do like 20 lectures, you sit an exam, which counts a little bit towards your final grade.
In the fourth year, the range of options is huge. When it comes to the research project, they could do the research project within the biochemistry department, but also people do their research project in oncology, in chemistry, in pathology, in pharmacology. I've had people who have been doing their part two project extracting DNA from historical artifacts for sequencing.
You come to study biochemistry and a lot of reading and patience is involved. And I say at first I probably didn't have a great deal of patience when like tackling research papers and reviews and textbooks and whatever else.
I'd have on average 3 hours, maybe four, of lectures a day from 9 until 12.
After lunch I'll usually go back to my room, maybe hit the library for a few hours, get some reading done for my one or two tutorials per week.
And then I have one or two classes a week. Each of those classes is just an hour and a half of going through work with about eight other students and a class teacher.
So labs will often run on from 11 till 5 each day that they're timetabled in. And they're good fun, really useful. Take up a lot of time though, and make tutorial work a bit difficult to fit in.
Often the thing that people struggle with the most is maths, if they haven't done it since GCSE, because it's only really in the first year, but you do need to be able to use maths and especially statistics.
In your first year exams, there is some kind of like quite a heavy problem solving element to the course. You move on to essay writing.
What we would like to see students achieve by the end of the course is the ability to take a biological problem and to be able to think about it as a biochemist would.
My favourite thing about Oxford has to be the Bodleian. It's probably the happiest place in the world. It has every book ever published in Britain, and that's just awesome.
The teaching labs we use for the two or three labs sessions we have a term are over in the zoology building, and they're pretty huge, like well equipped with everything you need.
Another great strength of the course is, of course, the tutorial system, where you get to spend a couple of hours, an hour or two a week, with a real expert in the field, just you and somebody else, which allows you to really explore the subject in a much more flexible way than you would in lectures. So one of the great things about being a tutor is that we only have two, three or four students in our college in each year who we look after. So you get to know them really well through the course. And so I give them tutorials every week. So in groups of two, usually, we have a cup of tea and some biscuits and we sit around and we talk about an area of science, and it's really fun to explore things. It gives them the opportunity to explore different areas.
It's a chance for a tutor to kind of probe how much students really know about a particular subject, and the students to ask questions to the tutor that specialises in this area.
I would get a whole kind of bullet pointed list of things that I should make notes on and learn, good textbooks to go to. That varies depending on the tutor. But you basically have to go away and just read and read and read for hours and then write an essay.
So the workload in Oxford is high. I'm not going to beat about the bush about that. There's a lot of work, particularly in the first year. Actually, the students find it quite a transition from A-level. So you should only really come here if you really enjoy your subject.
Students have to arrive with the expectation that there are going to be bits they struggle with, and not be worried by this, because everybody struggles.
Usually in your second year, you start having tutorials at other colleges with experts who really know their stuff.
I came on the unique summer school here the year before I applied university, and had a great week. I stayed at Keble College, spent the week kind of living a week in the life of a biochemistry student at Oxford. We did labs, went to lectures, had classes, tutorials, and the whole kind of Oxford education system just really appealed to me. I felt I really connected with it.
Because the biochemistry course is so much about problem solving, working out what question to ask, what experiment would then answer that question, how you would interpret the data as a result, we're much more interested in people who are interested in that approach, the process of solving problems, rather than just learning what other people have already found out.
If people come, you know, with an eagerness to learn things during the interview, an eagerness to explore ideas, and a willingness to think out aloud, that's great. Those are the people who do really well in the interview and come across really well.
Biochemistry interviews are almost invariably problem solving. We'll give people a problem, and we'll give people a problem that we know they don't know the answer to.
We want to set everybody at a level playing field, so it's not so much about what you know and what you've learned or what you've been taught, but more about we're looking for people whose minds work in the way in which they can explore problems with biochemistry and solve them and find out new things.
You'd go in and kind of start off with some fairly basic kind of A-level standard chemistry or biology style questions. And the tutors would essentially be looking to kind of work their way up to kind of harder scientific concepts, and like push you out of your comfort zone and see how you cope.
Tell us what you're thinking. Tell us how you're dissecting the problem. If you're stuck, tell us you're stuck. Tell us what sort of information might help to make it through to the next stage of the problem.
I seem to remember my tutors usually using a word that I didn't understand, and I was really embarrassed to ask what it meant, but I did it in the end. I needed to kind of know what that meant in order to ask the question. So yeah, I guess it's relatively important not to be not to be shy.
And what we're looking for is a logical, methodical approach to solving the problem, rather than whether they get the right answer at the end.
But really, interviews can feel like they've gone terribly wrong, and actually you've kind of been put through the mill because they've pushed you, because you can take it.
Now I look back on them, you can kind of tell they're trying to replicate kind of a tutorial scenario.
Biochemistry is not something that's taught at school in a systematic way. So they've got to make sure that they do actually understand what the subject involves.
Do a bit of reading around the subject. Perhaps try and read some popular science books, or have a look at some articles that you find interesting in New Scientist. I like the flexibility associated with biochemistry. With medicine, you're kind of destined to become some form of doctor, whereas with biochemistry, you have the flexibility. You could go into research. You could, if you choose, go into postgraduate medicine or pretty much anything.
Probably over 50% of our students carry on to do research, to do a doctorate in biochemistry or in a biochemistry-related field.
I'm now considering patent law as well, if I decide that research isn't the right way for me to go.
They go into all sorts of different things, from teaching to patent law to management consultancy to working in the city to working for charities to working for non-governmental organisations, and all sorts of different things. There's a huge variety.
I'm really glad I made the choice I did in applying for biochemistry and studying biochemistry, because it's something I really enjoy studying.